Let's put all this in perspective by looking at some actual numbers. To make things simple, let's let the length of our initial segment be 1 meter. Then we can look at a table, which uses our formula for curve length, that is 4 raised to the level number divided by 3 raised to the level number times 1, that is 1 meter here. Okay, so you can see that as the level goes up, the curve length also goes up. Why is that? Well, the reason is that each time we're dividing the segment length by 3, but we're multiplying the number of segments by 4. So the number of segments is going up faster than the segment length is going down. So by level 100, while the segment length is extremely small, on the order of 10 to the minus 48 power, that's a decimal place followed by 48 zeros before we get to any non-zero digits. But the number of segments has gone up astronomically to the order of 10 to the 60. So the actual curve length is 3.1 trillion meters. And what that means in more familiar terms is that the curve length at level 100 is 3 billion kilometers, or 2 billion miles. Now that's just amazing. Think for a minute what that means. What that means is even though we have the whole curve fits into our meter length ruler, it's able to squeeze in via these little nooks and crannies, like we saw on the coastline, an enormous amount of distance. This is not level 100. We really couldn't see the little nooks and crannies at level 100. But at level 100, the curve would be able to squeeze in about 2 billion miles within this meter length curve. That's just astounding. Of course, we don't see that much being squeezed into fractal structures in nature, but it gives us some hint as to why nature seems to prefer fractal structures. It's an extremely efficient way of squeezing in a huge amount of material, whether it be tree branches, or broccoli flowerets, or mountain landscapes, into a small amount of space. That is, that the curve is what's called space filling. There are many other examples of space-filling structures in nature, such as the veins, arteries, and capillaries that make up the blood transport system in the body, the roots of plants that grow underground, and structures in the brain. In all of these examples, a sort of fractal geometry is being used to optimize the amount of material that can be squeezed into a small amount of space. We'll hear more about this in the unit on scaling.